who's our local celebrity?
Local barbershop butcher.
Barbershop butcher. I need to come see you.
Statement CF1s for Olive Oak LLC in our Flagstaff Park. These two abatements are as written, year beginning 2009, and this was with the initial build and the 2017 of an additional building. If you look at their statement of benefits, it does show that they far exceeded both their salaries and their estimates on numbers of employees. It does show that they are in substantial compliance. What I would like to do is have a motion to approve both individually, and that will be, the first one would be the 2009 abatement, which was a 10-year abatement, and it was on the initial build of the building. Questions or comments?
I reviewed and say that they're in compliance as well, Tom, so if you want a motion to that effect, I will make that motion.
Motion to approve the initial build.
I'll second.
Motion made and seconded. All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Motion to approve the compliance statement for the addition of the building in 2017.
I'll make said motion.
Second. Motion made and seconded. All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Next, we have the CF1s. For Mount Olive Manufacturing. I apologize, gentlemen. There was a third one on the buildings, and I will need, and it was an addition to the buildings in 2014, and I will need a motion on it. I apologize.
I will make the motion to be approved.
Second.
Motion made and seconded. All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Next items are the the CF1 statement of benefits for the equipment. The initial equipment purchase of 2009. It did show that they were well within compliance on it. Have far exceeded both the number of employees and the amount of money on equipment. Motion to approve the 2009 abatement compliance statement.
I will make said motion.
Second.
Motion been made and seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay. The next one is a compliance statement on Mount Olive Manufacturing. This was for an additional purchase of equipment in 2015. Need a motion to approve it.
I'll make that motion as well.
Second.
Motion made and seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
I don't know if there's anyone here from Mount Olive. I would like to express my deepest gratitude as a council member for their investment into the community, their employment. They show a salary payroll of a little over $3.5 million. So let's keep that rolling. We can sure use the income tax.
Thank you very much.
Next item on the agenda is the sewer write-off. Andy, do you want to explain this?
We didn't do as well this year as we did last year.
Last year we had about half this, didn't we? These are bad debts that Sandy has given up on collecting. People are either gone, moved, or there was just no way to get back this revenue. She's kind of the enforcer. I think she went out with baseball bats and threatened and done all that she can do this year. Or this is write-offs from 2016. So these debts are over 2 years old. Total amount of the bad debt write-off is $2,784.10. I need a motion to approve or deny her writing them off and making her go back out and try to collect them some more.
I certainly don't want her to come after me with the baseball bat, so I'll make the motion.
I'll second.
Motion made and seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Sandy, you have to toughen up on these people.
Sandy, for the record, though, I know you did a great job with that, because I remember when we came in a long time ago, it was not quite so good. So, good job.
And I was teasing. I know you did a good job, but I know you're also awfully mean.
Sandy, thank you, and I think you're very nice.
You would be, won't that?
Well, she's going after you guys. Oh, okay. That's why I'm saying she's nice.
I need to send this one for sure. coming down, gentlemen, for signatures. Next item on the agenda is Mindy Taylor Street Closing. And as Mindy steps up to the plate, I want to remind everyone that today is the birthday of the Ford Mustang. The Ford debuted their Mustang in 1964. Wait a minute, there was someone else who had a birthday. Mindy, I want to wish you a happy birthday.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Happy birthday.
I appreciate you guys letting me come before you this evening. We didn't do this last year because of construction, and so pretty much it's the same as in the years past, although we are asking for the additional road cut or the closed meeting. So, any questions?
I have none. I looked at the thing. We've used it before. Certainly outstanding in Victoria, so I'm excited about it. So I would make the motion to work. I assume you talked to the grumpy chief back there. He's okay.
Yes, yes. And that's how I ended up proposing a map showing where the barricades are going to be. And Joe, I did find out the inflatable things that we're using for the kid zone are weighed down by sandbags, so there will not be any attaching it to the street or the parking lot.
I'll second Mark's motion.
Motion been made and seconded to allow the street closing on June 21st. All in favor?
Aye.
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 Thank you so much.
Thanks, Randy.
Happy birthday. Gentlemen, under unfinished business, I'd ask that we give an update on the Bell Fund, the restoration of the Bell. A kind and generous donation was made by the Fraternal Order of Eagles this past week for a total of $2,000 just from their organization. You know that we're targeting $5,600. Each one of us have applied what we can. We've had several businesses that have donated. We've had several individuals that have donated, and we appreciate that. Right now, our fund report shows that we are at $4,110. We're still targeting that $5,600. I have been in contact with JJ from Smith, Bach, and Bell, and he's still prepared to do it. We aren't running under any constraints. His price will go up tomorrow. But any help that the public can give, we would appreciate. We want to hear that bell ring again. I know Anthony has stated from Mooresville Times that anything that's donated within the next week, he will match.
Very nice. Appreciate that.
No, I think my editor will match.
Oh, okay. Under other business.
I sleep down.
I know last week we talked about the ideas for honoring Sam Davis. I know that Dustin was still working on a project that he may have. I know Mark was working on a project also. Is there any update that you would want to, either one of you would want to give at this time?
I'll give an update, and my project is, I am going to pull my idea due to working with another organization that is, shall we say, being troublesome. So I am going to pull my idea and let the other council members move forward with their ideas if they'd like.
Mark, have you, going back to your idea, have you talked to anyone or thought about anything as far as monuments or anything like that, or how you want to proceed?
Didn't really want us we wouldn't say waste or spend any time on that to have someone get quotes if we didn't know which direction we were going. I'd be glad to do that and have it available perhaps for next, some couple ideas for next meeting, if the council would like to do that.
I have no problem with that.
Mark, would you please proceed with that? Just see what we can do with it.
Well, so
Mine are the same day, it's not tomorrow.
Yeah.
Can't have a whole.
No.
I would like to pursue maybe the idea of honoring veterans, if you would, or the council would allow me to pursue an idea.
Okay.
With that, you had mentioned that at the last meeting, and maybe I could, in tandem with my other idea, do something with that.
I think that would be great. I would at least support that wholeheartedly also, I don't know, the rest of the council.
I should do that.
I'm good.
Please continue then.
Thank you.
Other business, Danny Allen. Chief Danny Allen.
You're grumpy, chief.
Grumpy, chief.
I don't know that you're grumpy all the time.
I just call him as I see him.
Smile all the time.
Thank you. Especially with one something.
Absolutely, when I want something, I'm smiling for you. I'm here tonight to ask your permission to start a process to replace a dispatcher that vacated her position with us.
Motion to approve.
I'll second.
Are you really worried about me being that grumpy? I mean, it's pretty quick.
Well, I mean, guys, just want to see a dispatcher.
We don't want to see Danny taking that job. Motion been made and seconded for Chief Allen to proceed with the hiring process to replace a vacated position. Do I have it? I do have a second. All in favor?
Aye.
At our last meeting, oh, sorry.
Thank you.
Hey, thank you. Go hire that dispatcher.
Yeah, thanks.
At our last meeting, Tess Inc. did not show up to our meeting. They have reached out. What Tess Inc. is a third-party construction company that is looking at running a single line. This is not fiber optic throughout the town. This is running a single line to our two existing cell phone towers. What they're wanting to do is either use the overhead system where available or underground where it is not. I have spoken in great detail to them about our South Indiana Street project and how we would really like to stay away from that, and they have been extremely cooperative and have engineers looking at that at this time. They assured me that there is some confidentiality with the company, but they did assure me that the company that they are doing this for is doing this venture to enhance the cell phone service throughout our community and also enhance the data capability, the 4G networking, and so on and so forth. That was all that they had. They did inquire of our easement process. I discussed that with Dave, discussed that with them, and put them in touch with Dave, or give them Dave's contact on anything that they would need to do should they dig in our rights of way. So that was the update for that. Legal counsel.
Nothing tonight, thank you.
Did you make the move?
Made the move as of yesterday. I'm in the new office. As of today, we're probably got about 80% of our electronics transferred, and all the files are there. In boxes.
Okay.
As organized as we hope to be soon, but yes, I'm there.
Congratulations to you and the firm.
Our half of box, though, is, I'm sure, still readily available.
Comments from the floor today.
Got a couple of things to come up there, or is this good?
Can you speak loudly?
Yes, I can. You know I can do that. If you could, I would just like a couple updates from past meetings, if you have anything new that you could share. One is the update on the police station. Is anything coming about of that? Because I've noticed not much is going on, at least from the outside. I haven't noticed any cars around or working there. And update on the advertising sign. I know that's from talking with Dustin, that's a private entity there, and you guys were looking to get money from that, to recoup money from that, to put on the gateway project to pay for that.
We do receive monthly rent. Whether that sign has anything on it or not, we receive a monthly rent from the private sector that owns that sign. And yes, we have started receiving money from that.
Excellent.
So, as far as the police station, we have Joe and Mark that have kind of taken over that.
We are getting real close to doing the initial bids, the four bids. Trying to decide which way we're going to go on that. So, yeah, we're working on it. There's not any activity, but we are working on it.
Okay. And with the boulder back in the park, is there any way that could be moved up to a more visible spot, the Samuel Moore boulder, the plaque with the plaque on it? And just asking.
I'm not sure that there's even been any discussion yet, Dave.
Okay. Well, there has been at the shop. That's why I'm bringing it up. I figured I'd just let you guys know.
Appreciate it.
And one other thing I noticed when...
Well, let's stop on that just a second. Now, I've had comments the other way that they say with the end of the new park, people walking through the park, that that's really better than where it was before. I've had those kind of comments.
Yeah. Okay.
As well.
I'm just asking, just asking a question.
Well, they put it there for a reason because they thought with the concert series and everything else, it would be a great spot for that.
Mm-hmm.
And so I've had people comment on that. I think I've even seen it in print media that some people say that's a great spot for it. So I'm just saying that there's a counterpoint there.
Yeah, exactly. That's fine. Perfect. Just ask some questions so I can maybe answer questions when I get asked at the shop. And one other thing, I noticed there hasn't been any department updates in months. Have you stopped that, or is that going to start again?
I think what we've done in the past is we've kind of given the guys a chance to catch their breath. Everyone has been behind the eight ball as far as projects that they're working on. We are running to a degree from fire to fire as far as the police are here, or the police department is well represented at every meeting. We're having them address that. Each one of us are provided with the totals, and then Chief Allen has started updating WCBK with our monthly totals as far as citations, warnings, stops, initiated calls, CAD calls, so on and so forth. Dave, we've made him come because of the bid process that we went through on our streets, and we've asked him if he needs to catch his breath on it. The last time that we had an update from our fire chief, it cost us $1.386 million, so we just really didn't want any more updates from him. I think each one of us can stay in contact and will stay in contact, but it is something that I think we all wanted, and I think we're going to try to get the guys back on the same page as far as, instead of having each one of them give a report at a meeting, maybe stagger them out as we go through.
You find, I think it's just something to be interesting for us to hear what goes on around the town.
We're trying to be a little more use our local radio station a little bit better than what we have in the past. Anthony, with his very generous donation for the bell restoration, we're going to try to get him more information also.
That's great. Thank you, Anthony.
Cleanup days is being organized, and then you have sign-up sheets. If there's anybody here interested in, have got any groups that's interested in participating in cleanup day on May 19th, there's sign-up sheet here at the end of the table if anybody wishes to. There's a form to fill out.
Joe, did we see a flyer on that? Was there a flyer that we made up?
Yes.
Yeah, there's some flyers down here, Tom. There's a few down here. You want one?
Yeah. No, but I'm sure Anthony would love to have one of those.
That's going to be at the Old Town Park.
Okay.
At Shepherd House. At 9 o'clock on that day, May 19th. They will provide, I think you said, this is like breakfast. I think you're talking to us.
Yeah, appreciate you taking the initiative and starting that.
We need you to sign that.
What sign of everyone from the Mooresville Times? The county council? I think they should have a team.
That was the fun, wasn't it?
We all know that relationship. We had someone from Allen & Son Barbershop.
There you go. I could put a team together if you guys do.
Done.
I just keep your mobile working.
And also, I'd like to thank Street Department and Dave for getting the trash cans back out on the street that's been missing for a little bit.
Does it look better?
Greatly appreciated. I don't know, I just saw them today.
Okay, because they had them already done.
Yeah.
That's why they went out there.
Anything else from the council? Motion for approval of payment of claims.
Make a motion that we approve claims in the amount of $396,083.18. I'll get you a calculator and you can look for it.
Motion been made. Do I have a second?
Second.
Motion made and seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Gentlemen, we need a motion to adjourn.
I make said motion.
Motion been made. Do I have a second?
Second.
Motion made and seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
We're adjourned. Next meeting date is May 1st. 2018. Guys, what do you think? About 6:30?
Sounds good.
Okay, see y'all there. That was on. Keep going.